Hi, I'm Tara Hitchcock. You are watching Harkins Theaters Behind the Screens. We're actually in one of the refurbished theaters here at the Arizona Mills location in Arizona. And we're talking about the film Stillwater today, starring Oscar winner Matt Damon. He plays a father trying to exonerate his daughter imprisoned in France for murder. It is a crime thriller loosely based on the Amanda Knox case. Harkins Behind the Screens had a chance to talk to the cast and the Oscar-winning director behind the film, Tom McCarthy. Some folks are born made
to wear the fly. You're in Marseille for vacation?
Yeah, I'll visit my daughter.
Yet the father of the girl, the American student?
Yes, ma'am.
I heard that you thought, or actually were surprised by the fact that Matt was such a quick study. And I was curious, what were you expecting?
It's a great question. I don't know, but like, you know, it was fun. You know, it's still Matt Damon, and I've known Matt over the years. We've talked about other projects, you know, run into him time to time, but I didn't really know him. And suddenly we just like, I was coming from New York. He was coming from LA. We met in Oklahoma. We got in a rental car and just drove around and, you know, ate barbecue and drank beer and sat with roughnecks and interviewed people and attended, you know, family dinners. And we really got to know each other. And what I loved just how efficient he was. I mean, he's got a full life. He's got four kids of his own, and he knew I need to get boots on the ground, and I need to start paying attention and digging in on this character. And I was like, wow, he really wants to just start doing it. You know, some people slow roll up to roll. Matt's like, all right, let's go.
You did such a great job playing this guy. And I talked to Tom, obviously, about your trips to Oklahoma and hanging with these guys. I'm curious, what part of being a roughneck did the guys you met with not want you to mess up, even though you're Matt Damon?
Well, no, it was really the whole thing. We really had to impart to them how accurate we were trying to be. You know, I think there was a justifiable wariness at the beginning. It's like, what is this Hollywood thing? What are you doing? You're coming down here. You're going to be a roughneck. Like, what's going on? Like, what's your agenda? And I think once they got to know us and see what the movie that we were making and realize that the movie has tremendous compassion and empathy for this guy, they gave us unbelievable access. And, you know, they don't want me to mess any of it up.
That's a great question. I think it was just like, you know, look, there's one guy, Kenny Baker, who we talked to a lot. And Kenny is terrific. And he, you know, success story, like, you know, not all roughnecks, like in any job, not everyone's successful, right?
Right.
And it's really hard work and it's really intense. And some guys succeed and some guys don't, just like anything else. And I think what Kenny mostly said is like, hey, we're not rednecks. You know,
right.
We're smart, hardworking, God-fearing, family-loving, community-concerned parents and people, and bring that.
It's about acceptance.
Acceptance of what?
Your fate.
I love the whole concept of hope versus acceptance. And I'm sure as a parent, you have provided your daughters at times little false hope versus just being honest. As a parent, how much of that should be allowed? What do you prefer?
Oh, that's tough. I think it's a case by case basis. You know, you go like, right, when is it okay to you know, when should you be giving them hope, and when should you be letting them know, like, look, this is the way it is. I mean, I think back to, you know, my father explaining to me that I wasn't going to be in the NBA when I was 12 years old. You know, it was a very necessary conversation, and he was saving me a lot of anguish by knocking it out early and explaining that he was the tallest Damon ever to evolve at 5'11", and my favorite player's name was Tiny Archibald, because Tiny was 6'1". So he was like, look, it ain't going to happen.
I went to the gift shop and I saw this necklace.
I want to ask you also about gift giving when it comes to your daughters. There's that beautiful scene. By the way, that actress, I'm a stickler when it comes to kid actors. They can ruin an entire film for me. And this young girl is so fantastic.
Yeah.
You're shopping for a gift for Abigail's character, and you're really lost. What is the best gift you've ever purchased for one of your daughters where you nailed it? You actually got the greatest gift ever.
The best gift, I think, that I've ever... So last Christmas... my wife, it was a 1-2 punch. We gave my 15-year-old a life-size cardboard cutout of Harry Styles. For Harry Styles did a little video and said hello to her, and she lost her mind. Yeah, that was, I think that was that was the best we've done. so far.
I don't know. I feel like that's actually not fair. Like, you are Matt Damon. I feel like you just, there's no way anybody can compete with that if they're a dad.
I didn't know he was going to do it. I was like, I'm forever grateful to him. I really owe him one. I don't know how I would ever repay or what I could possibly repay with, but that was pretty cool.
And last, as they wrap me up, when it goes back to hope and acceptance, has there been a no? You know, in this world, we get a lot of no's. We get told no all the time, and it's our job to continue on regardless or to not accept the no. What was the no that was the hardest for you to accept and took you the longest time to really find that letting go and acceptance?
There have been a lot. Obviously, as you know, in this business, we deal with rejection constantly. I think one of the tougher ones was when Ben and I auditioned for Dead Poets Society, which was such a beautiful script. And we got pretty close enough that we were called back a few times, I think, and didn't get the part and ended up working in our hometown at a movie theater that had one screen and only played Dead Poets Society for the entire summer. And we had to, like, we were the ticket tearer, you know, the usher, and we had to serve the popcorn and drinks for like 2.5 months to people who were walking out every day bawling their eyes out because Dead Poets was so beautiful. That was a tough one.
And that's how I felt for a really long time. Powerless and forgotten.
You know, the prison scenes, I had heard that you guys kind of shot all of those back to back, basically. I mean, what was that experience like? I know you did some research as it relates to inmates.
Yeah. I mean, getting the film in the actual prison was, you know, really helpful. And all the guards that you see in the film are real guards that work there. So they actually walked me through what my day-to-day life would kind of be like in there. And that definitely helped. But yeah, it was definitely a very, very long, long week of sitting in a room day after day and doing these really intense scenes. I mean, there was really not, there was no kind of break in the intensity. So but I'm kind of glad that we filmed it that way. That way you don't have to go too up and down with your emotions.
Well, and there is a moment where she gets a little taste of freedom. I'm wondering, you know, time to me is the most precious commodity, and sadly we don't have enough of it. So if you do get a free day, what is your best way to spend that time?
I mean, I'm such a homebody. I really just like being at home, hanging out with my friends, watching Dance Moms all day. Nothing very like exciting or interesting, but I cherish my downtime.
Any good downtime with Matt Damon in France? Did you guys get to run around on the in Marseille and eat some pommes frites?
Well, there was actually this really great pizza place that we all got to go to when we were in Marseille for the Marseille premiere recently. So that was fun. My boyfriend got to play cards with him one night.
Oh.
I think that was probably the coolest thing that's ever happened to my boyfriend. So that made his life.
Let's go.
What'd he say?
Nothing. He's useless.
I think you honestly had, I'm a big stickler when it comes to relationships. And if a relationship feels forced or if they go from point A to point B too quickly, honestly, you've lost me. And in your case, you have to establish this very subtle, slow-moving and realistic relationship that builds over time. What is the key to that? Because to me, that was, I mean, obviously Matt's a great actor, but so are you. What was the key in your opinion to that?
Well, I think something that really helped was also Tom McCarthy filming chronologically. So really, Matt and I, we really, when I knock on the door to introduce myself, this is the first day of the shoot. And also, I think the script, we're always coming back to the script, but the script really made it very, very, I think this is questions that they've been asking themselves, because it was a challenge. When you meet the two characters, it's a challenge to make them come to that point B, as you say, and make it real. And I think there were a lot of elements in the script that really fed this relationship and make it grow. And the relationship to children is also something that made them come together, and that also tore them apart, I think. So this is interesting.
You do your homework? Homework?
Ah, no.
Okay, can we actually talk about the other thing that can ruin a movie for me, a child actor? No offense. And in this case, she was fantastic. Who is this amazing girl?
I know, it's her first movie. She's a dancer. She dances a lot. But I have to say that her personality equals her acting. She's somebody you know, I thought if we were the same age, I definitely want to be her girlfriend, her friend. I mean, you know, and I think she's an old soul. She comes from, there's something that comes from the past. I don't know, because there's grace. She's in France we say virtuose. I don't know if you have like a Mozart. She's a Mozart of the acting, you know. Why did Mozart sit at a piano and started playing? Well, I think she's the same with acting. It was amazing to watch.
You sound very American right now.
Good, I am.
Yeah, and you're also a stranger here.
What did you do?
You just have to trust me.
Yeah, the entire cast is great, actually. Don't forget to like us on Facebook, Harkins Theaters, for your movie news, promotions, and giveaways. I hope you enjoyed my cast interviews for the film Stillwater. I'm going to get back to the movies and back to this big bag of Harkins popcorn. The best.